You may have noticed it before. You install a package using npm, and suddenly a new file appears in your folder called package-lock.json. This is a file that is now generated by npm since npm version 5 released in 2017. It does what the name suggests. It helps to lock our package dependencies down and all of their sub-dependencies. In this tutorial, we'll learn about package-lock.json files, review why package-lock was added to npm, and outline the reasons why lockfiles should be used by your application. A project's dependency tree represents all the dependencies used, their sub-dependencies, and the relationships between them. Packages you install typically rely on other packages, and those rely on their own packages, and so on forever. When you install a package using the npm CLI, it also installs all the sub-dependencies to your node modules directory. But because that process is abstracted away from us, it can introduce some issues. If there's something wrong with the sub-dependency of a package you've installed, it can create issues in your application which can be hard to debug. Package-lock.json is a snapshot of your entire dependency tree and contains the information the npm CLI needs to recreate the exact state of all the modules in your node modules directory. When a package-lock.json file is present in your project, npm install will respect the package-lock file's version of the dependency tree and recreate the state of your node modules directory as described by the package-lock file. This means you'll always install the exact same versions of dependencies and sub-dependencies referenced in the package-lock file. The point of a package-lock file is that it can help us avoid dependency drift, which is when there are slight differences between dependencies across different environments or developers working on a project. Let's say we install a package to our project, we'll call it foo-lib, and it depends on a package called bar-lib. You use foo-lib directly in your app, and everything is working fine. But at some point later on, an update is published to bar-lib, which introduces a bug. Then, on a fresh install of your project, the bug in bar-lib completely breaks your project. From your perspective, nothing in your code has changed at all. Your package.json never changed, and you're not relying on bar-lib directly as a dependency, but the state of your node modules directory changed when foo-lib's dependency bar-lib was updated to the new version. Now you're getting an error, and so far as you can tell, you haven't changed anything at all. This is the exact sort of scenario that package-lock.json can help you avoid. If your project had a package-lock.json file, then npm install would have reproduced the exact state of your node modules directory from when the package lock was created. In this scenario, the buggy version of bar-lib would never have been installed. Package-lock.json ensures that you get the same version of each dependency and subdependency each time you run npm install. To be useful, you should track your package-lock.json file in your version control system. That way, the file is distributed with your project, and every time someone runs npm install in your project, they will get the exact same version of the dependency tree, eliminating the version drift and the hard-to-debug issues that come with it. Here's an example package-lock.json file. You can see the dependencies and their sub-dependencies are tracked along with their version numbers. This file isn't meant to be edited manually. If one doesn't exist, it will be generated after running an npm install. Once a package-lock file already exists in your project, it will be updated whenever your dependency tree changes. This can be by adding, upgrading, or removing dependencies. Again, your package-lock.json file is something you should commit to version control. Some of the benefits of doing so are tracking the state of your node modules folder without having to actually check the folder itself into version control. Checking in your node modules folder is considered an anti-pattern with Node.js because we want to keep our Git history clean and not worry about changes in code that we didn't write. Checking in your package lock allows you to time travel back to a previous state of your node modules folder whenever you want. This way, you can see exactly when a sub-dependency changed or use a previous version of your node modules directory. Likely the biggest advantage of keeping your package lock file checked into your version control system is ensuring that every developer working on a project will have the same dependency tree. This helps cut down on works on my machine type problems due to the dependency drift like in the scenario we discussed earlier. To recap, package-lock.json is a snapshot of your node modules directory, which records the versions of dependencies and their subdependencies used in your project, which make up the dependency tree. Using a package-lock file will ensure the same dependency tree is installed by everyone who runs your application. Package-lock.json is created when running npm install and is updated by the npm CLI whenever your dependency tree changes. You should commit your package-lock file into version control to make sure it is distributed with your project, and use npm shrinkwrap when you want to lock dependencies for packages you publish to npm.